Welcome back to Binge-Worthy Network. Broken TVs and called police. This is the time Blac Chyna destroyed Kylie Jenner's house. Before we get into this video, if you are a fan of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. For those of you who have been keeping up with the Kardashians now, you know that Blac Chyna is undeniably one of the worst figures of the reality TV show. Not only was she heavily disliked by the Kardashian fans, but the Mega Million Dollar family considered her to be their arch nemesis. And while some viewers remember Blac Chyna as Rob's ex-fiance and Dream's mother, Chyna's and the Kardashian family's history goes way back. So before we get to Chyna destroying Kylie's house on purpose, let's see exactly why the reality TV family hates the model so much. It's no secret that Kylie Jenner and Tyga's relationship was one of the most followed romances in the entertainment business. The youngest Kardashian-Jenner sibling and the rapper first got together in early 2014, and the couple was together for more than 2 years before they finally called it quits in 2016. But what does Blac Chyna have to do with Kylie and Tyga? Well, numerous sources and close insiders have confirmed that Tyga was dating Chyna when he first got together with Kylie. At the time, Tyga and Chyna had been together for a few years and even shared their son, King. Not only were they dating, but Chyna and Tyga were actually engaged. And that's when Kylie came into the picture and stole Tyga from Chyna. Ever since then, Blac Chyna has been out to destroy the Kardashian family. It seemed like the tension between the Kardashians and Blac Chyna had dialed down for a few years until Chyna reappeared in the Keeping Up with the Kardashian family. This time, she was the proud girlfriend of the youngest Kardashian sibling, Rob Kardashian. The whole world was shocked to see Rob betray his family and stand next to the woman who had hurt them on numerous occasions. But if dating Chyna wasn't bad enough, Rob announced he was engaged to the model only a few months after dating. This engagement took everyone by surprise, as no member of the Kardashian family knew about Rob's plans. Their sudden romance was heavily documented by the Keeping Up with the Kardashian cameras, and the viewers couldn't wait to see how Rob and Chyna's relationship would evolve. The couple gained so much attention and fame, they were even handed their very own reality TV show. The show, named Rob and Chyna, wanted to document their romance and how it blossomed day to day. But unfortunately, the viewers got anything but romance and love. Their reality TV show gave the world an insight into their dysfunctional relationship. Not only were the audiences shocked to see how unfit the pair were for one another, but their drama got so huge and big, even the Kardashians had to chime in. In April of 2017, before their drama had reached its peak, Rob and Chyna decided to rent one of Kylie's many mansions in Los Angeles. The pair hadn't bought a house for themselves yet, and they thought renting out Kylie's house was the perfect decision. While no one is sure what really happened on that April afternoon, Rob and Chyna ended up in a very heated argument. The fight went from yelling at each other to actually throwing things across the rooms. Rob admitted how Chyna got so upset, she started destroying anything she could find. Apparently, Chyna went absolutely berserk and started trashing Kylie's house. She broke vases, glasses, plates, and even her TV. Kylie opened up about the incident and confessed how Kris Jenner had to get involved. The self-made billionaire has stated, "My mom calls me and apparently Chyna threw something at my television. It's a little disrespectful, and I wouldn't do that to someone else's home." It's really hard to support a relationship that's really unhealthy. I wish they would both stop the roller coaster ride. But Kylie wasn't the only Kardashian sister that had to get involved and voice their concerns. Kim Kardashian is undeniably one of the most outspoken of the Kardashian-Jenner sisters, and the mother of four had no problem putting Rob back into his right place. Even though the sisters loved their younger brother, Kim had a problem with how Rob was handling the situation. She didn't think displaying their problems to the entire world was the best way to handle their issues. In one Keeping Up with the Kardashians episode, Mrs. Kardashian West opened up about Rob and Chyna and how she feels about their relationship. "Rob started Snapchatting his thoughts and feelings, and that's really not like him," said the KKW beauty owner. "I have always felt that them as a couple just isn't that healthy, and I think they know that too. Rob really can be irrational, and he just has to learn to really take responsibility for himself and not blame it on Chyna. This just all has to stop. It's clear what this relationship is. They're just not meant to be with each other." And the entire family agreed with Kim. the Kardashian-Jenner household got so tense, all the sisters eventually stopped talking to their one and only brother. Kylie would not talk to Rob for a few weeks, and Khloe even refused to see her younger brother. That's when Kris Jenner came in. The momager begged her daughters to take back Rob and try to forgive him and his stupid mistakes, but no matter how much Kris begged and pleaded, it wasn't enough for the sisters to forgive Rob's betrayal. After Chyna and Rob broke up for the last time, Kris knew she had to take some action in order to glue her family back together. Many sources have confirmed that Kris was trying her hardest to unite the siblings. Kris has told Kendall, Kylie, Khloe, Kim, and Courtney to all reach out to Rob. She is worried that he will spiral when he sees Black Chyna getting on with her life and dating a new guy. She knows this is tough for her son, said one insider. Not only did Kris want her kids to all get along, but she also advised her girls to look after Dream. 3-year-old Dream is undeniably one of the cutest Kardashian-Jenner kids, and she truly does not deserve all the hate. After all, it's not her fault that Rob and Chyna had a rocky relationship from the start, and that's why Kris encouraged her older children to involve Dream in more family activities and just make her feel welcome. Kris wants them all to reach out to him and his baby daughter Dream to make them feel part of the family. She especially wants Kim and Courtney to make a special effort to integrate Dream with their kids, as she believes this would really help Rob in the long run. And while the sisters have accepted Dream with open arms, Rob's relationship with the girls is still uncertain. But if you thought Rob and Chyna's relationship drama ended with their called-off engagement in 2017, well, you couldn't be more wrong. Chyna and Rob recently made headlines once again after Chyna claimed Dream got injured while visiting her dad. On July 30th of 2020, the entertainment industry got an insight on Chyna and Rob's co-parenting style. After years of battling one another in court, the former couple had finally devised a parenting plan that would benefit them both. Chyna would get to see Dream a couple of days a week, and Rob would get to do the same. And while their co-parenting seemed to be going okay for a few months, that all changed when Chyna accused Rob of hurting his very own daughter. In the recent court documents, Black Chyna claims that their daughter, Dream, suffered multiple head injuries while visiting her dad, Rob. Over the past 4 months, the minor child, Dream Renee Kardashian, suffered 2 severe burns on her legs while in the care of respondent's nanny, said Chyna's attorney, Lynn Chiani. Lynn also continued to explain how Dream would come home extremely sad and worried. According to the attorney, Rob would deny any claims of the multiple incidents and would even call out Chyna for lying about Dream's bumps. The court documents later exposed the text messages between Chyna and Rob, where Rob explains what happened to Dream and how she ended up with little bumps on her head. "Hey, Dream slipped running and bumped her head on the wall. She has a bump on her forehead area. I put ice on it and arnica cream and it will go down, but just letting you know, I will send home the cream also for you to use. She is fine and it'll go down, so don't worry. We're playing now and she isn't in any pain or anything. Just wanted to keep you posted." And while this message might look convincing and truthful, Chyna has a different story to tell. Even though she said she fell down the stairs, the model still didn't feel like her daughter was telling the truth. For the last 4 months, Dream has returned home with several similar incidents that raise a few eyebrows. And that's why Chyna decided to take action against Kardashian. In the court documents, Black Chyna is asking to reduce Rob Kardashian's visitation hours from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, instead of Dream staying over from Friday to Saturday. Chyna's attorney backed up the story and Rob's behavior by stating, "Whether due to his depression or other medical condition, respondent clearly is not able to competently supervise his nannies or to keep Dream safe while in his care." No matter what the court decides, or if Rob's visitation hours get reduced, it's an undeniable fact that Rob and Chyna were just not good for one another. From multiple fights and public meltdowns to trashing family homes, Rob and Chyna proved to be one of the worst couples in Keeping Up with the Kardashian family. And we can all agree that Kylie did not deserve her house to be damaged and destroyed because of petty fights and uncontrolled behavior. What do you think? Should Chyna apologize for Kylie? What would you do in the billionaire situation? Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe and give us a like. And don't forget to turn on your post notifications and share this video with your friends. Later, everyone.